Netherlands is proud to host the third Nuclear Security Summit in The Hague. This summit will survey the achievements of the past 4 years and define the challenges that lie ahead. In this message, we will tell you more about the progress the Netherlands is making.
The Netherlands has been very active in reducing the amounts of nuclear material around the world. And as a matter of fact, in the Netherlands, we have eliminated the use of high-enriched uranium as fuel in our different reactors.
We were one of the first in the world to convert our fuel from high-enriched to low-enriched uranium. And we're in the process, together with our customers, of converting the targets necessary for the production of these isotopes from high-enriched to low-enriched uranium as well.
The Dutch Ministry of Economic Affairs is responsible for handling nuclear licenses according to our Dutch nuclear law, including security and environmental requirements.
Nuclear security worldwide is very important. Although we assess the threat of nuclear terrorism as low, the impact can be enormous. And that's why we invest in all kinds of measures. For example, we try to enhance the security within the nuclear facilities. And at the same time, we try to ensure that crisis management is in place just in case something happens.
And we have been active in international cooperation for decades already in drafting the different conventions we have in this field. Especially, of course, in the last few years, now that we are chairman of this Nuclear Security Summit process.
Well, the Netherlands has given a very good example, I think. We invited IPAS missions in all facilities in the Netherlands and had also a follow-up mission to check on the implementation of recommendations from the IPAS mission.
The Kingdom of the Netherlands is an active partner and effective contributor to the global nuclear security. It is party to the International Convention on the Physical Protection of Nuclear Material, CPNM, and its amendments, and it's one of the most comprehensive users of our peer reviews.
Most important is that we actually test the performance of the nuclear security measures. We do that both with our industry-based force-on-force team on an unannounced basis, which is quite unique. As also in collaboration with the National Police.
Dutch nuclear law is currently being updated on the basis of state-of-the-art knowledge. And this includes additional security requirements, such as protecting installations from possible cyber attacks.
And a thing worthwhile to mention is the atomic exercise, a tabletop exercise on CBRN terrorism, which the Dutch are very proud of to organize a couple of times in the last years, also in spring 2014, in which all countries in the world work together and try to define what they can do and work together in close cooperation just in case a nuclear incident really happens.
The other thing in the summit is that we have launched an initiative asking countries to commit also to implement IAEA recommendations and have implementation checked by IPAS missions. And I hope, and we all hope, that many countries will follow.
Many solutions for these problems originate in a community of experts, scientists, and representatives of NGOs. Klingendaal is one of them.
One of the things we have been doing the last few years is establishing a Master of Nuclear Security here associated to the Delft University of Technology. So it's on academic level, and it means that you get people into courses like that. You teach to be alert, teach to be critical, teach to view information and not only absorb it.
When nuclear material is being smuggled, the most important question is finding out who did the smuggling. And this you can find out by looking at the traces left by the perpetrators on the material. And this is where forensics comes in. The importance of forensics is that there's so much information contained in trace material that you can find the perpetrators just by the trace material alone.
Well, a lot has been done by the Kingdom of the Netherlands and our member states in nuclear security. But still, a lot remains to be done. Nuclear security, like nuclear safety, is work in progress. So we have to continuously improve nuclear security infrastructure nationally, regionally and globally.
Securing nuclear material will remain a task for current and future generations. This is why the Netherlands, as a country dedicated to peace and justice, is committed to the objectives of the Nuclear Security Summit. With our country and others, we are working together for a safer world.
Let me say that we are proud of what we do.